Okay, so hi everyone. I have no idea whether I'm actually live or not. So, because we can't check this somehow technically from this site, so, and I won't see any thumbs up either. So Leon is trying to figure out with Kirsty if... So I think I'm live, right? Oh, I'm live. Okay. In that case, fine. We just don't see the chat, but... As long as you can hear me, I'm happy. I'll read all about all of your things that have happened during the week. I'll read about it later, hopefully. Right, so how are you all? I'm good. I'm good. What can I say? So what I want to talk to you about today is a little bit more about compassion for yourself and about mindfulness. Yeah? So... the first step of mindfulness is really recognizing what's going on for you in the moment. And the question you can ask yourself is, what's happening inside of me? And then pause for a moment to feel your sensations, how you feel, your bodily sensations, how you feel, your thoughts, just generally like what's happening inside of me. And then the second entrance into mindfulness is, can you be with it? Yeah, it's then taking that pause to stay with it. So allow. So it would be the question, can I be with this without judgment, without needing to change anything, without trying to fix it? Can I just be with what is? And that in itself already... If you can just do that a few times during your day, in itself already changes so much for you. And I hope you're already practicing that, but it's just a very easy two things to ask yourself. What's happening inside of me is recognize. Take a moment to go inward and ask yourself, what's happening inside of me? And then, can I be with it for a moment? Can I just... stay with it without judgment? Can I allow it to be? And so that's what we'll do in the meditation later as an entrance point. And then the other thing that I wanted to talk about a little bit more is the whole idea of yielding. And yielding is where you give into gravity in a way. So you let go of the weight of your body, you're connecting with the earth. It's almost an active letting go. But we don't collapse. Eh? If you completely yield, you'll fall asleep. So it can be a collapse. It's not that. It's a letting go and at the same time keeping an alertness, a dignity, if you like, that you also are able to feel the rebound of the letting go, of the gravity. The rebound is a lightness. So it's not a collapse, but it's also not a holding up. Like, this is me if I'm not conscious. Like, this is my sort of what I would do in life if I would not be if I'm not aware. Is I would just prop myself up. I'd be like holding myself up very actively away from the floor, and I forget to trust that the earth holds me and supports me. And from that letting go, and you can really feel that when you give into the earth and you connect with the ground, and we've done that in the meditations where you really go there and but still remaining a little bit of active, you can find that middle ground where you yield, you let go, and at the same time rebound, feeling the lightness. I hope that makes sense. And this has an immediate effect on being present, has an immediate effect on the state of your being. This is also a pause. And if you combine that, the yielding for a moment, with the steps of what's going on inside of me and can I be with it, that's really powerful. And so there's many ways of arriving to presence, and it's a lot of the times it's about finding what works for you. So that consciously letting go into gravity while you do maintain alert, and but not propping yourself up, but alert and awake. Even imagining yourself sitting on a sort of a soft grass or helps to change the tone in your body. And then you become relaxed, present. And then you ask yourself, okay, what's going on inside? Just ask yourself, what's going on inside of me? Am I calm? What do you feel sensation-wise? How do you feel emotionally? And can I be with that? Can I just give space to that? And this is what we call sacred space. So between the stimulus and the response, there is a space. And this is almost what you can do for yourself. And in that space is your choice for freedom and your power. So you can find in that space your freedom and your power. Your freedom to choose to respond differently than you would normally out of your old habits do. And again, the power to do that. So it's a super important place to recognize is that moment of, okay, hang on a moment. And there is your ability to change the direction of where things are going within yourself. I hope that makes sense. Okay, so let's start moving a little bit before the time is up for that. Come to all fours. And place your hands underneath your shoulders and the knees underneath the hips. And just begin to sway a little bit with the hips. Very gentle sway, and let that movement translate into the lower spine. So when the hips sway to one side, the rib cage almost sways to the other side. And you can come onto your knees, take your feet off the floor, and let your legs be part of this. And then let this movement travel up the spine, lower back, mid back, upper back, into the neck. And if this doesn't feel quite natural to you, that's okay. It just means you have to actually do this a couple of more times for yourself, because that the fluidity of one part of the spine responding to the next part of the spine, responding to the next part of the spine, has been lost a little bit, but you can bring that back. Close your eyes. Feel the movement and yield. Give the weight to the floor at the same time, staying alert and active. And let this translate all the way into your neck and into your... And if you find this easier with your feet on the floor, please do so. Adjust as accordingly and feel those sticky bits that don't move fluidly. And don't worry about them. We acknowledge and we allow without needing to change it or judge it, so with compassion. Okay, good. Come back to neutral. And just here, take a little circle with the head one way, a little circle with the head the other way. And just look over your left shoulder and look over your right shoulder and then tuck your toes under. Place your hands a little further forward and exhaling, pressing back, taking your hips up. And yield here, as in letting the weight travel through the spine, through the shoulders, through the bones of the arms, through the palms of the hands, into the floor, keeping a certain gentle, relaxed tone to the body. And then feel that rebound traveling up through the arms and the spine as well, and lifting your hips up and back as a result of that. So there's a letting go downwards and a traveling back up, upwards. And you can only do this when the elbows are soft, when the knees are soft. When we stiffen, that yielding and rebounding is very difficult to find. So keep those elbows
soft. And those knees unlocked. The jaw relaxed. Pedal the legs, moving the hips a little from side to side. Inhaling and exhaling, both knees back down. Draw the hands a little closer. Inhale, take your cow pose, lower the belly, take your chest up. Look up, feel. And exhaling, gently rounding again. Releasing the weight down into the floor. Feel that rebound of the lift. One more time, inhale. Your back bend. And exhale. Rounding the spine. Okay. Place your hands further forward. Inhale, tuck your toes. One more time. Exhale, downward facing dog. Find that yield again. Feel the stretch in the backs of the legs in a gentle way. And then walk your feet to your hands or your hands towards your feet. Let the body be heavy. Head, neck, arms. Deep breath in and relaxing breath out. Find a yielding here. So bend your knees till you feel the, and you bend your knees a lot. You take your hips down so that you feel the weight coming down into the legs. And from there, it's going to be really easy to roll up. So bend those knees enough. Feel the weight shifting in your legs. A little bit of engagement along the front of the body. And then press the floor away as you lift up to standing. Wonderful. And then we come down as well. So take your shoulders back, lift your chest a little, and then begin to let your head hang. Begin to let your shoulders hang, bending those knees. A little bit of engagement along the front of the body. And as soon as you feel the upper body gets heavy, shift back and feel the floor. Feel the weight down, going down through the legs. So you're getting back into that consciously letting go to the floor. Yeah, so we're not letting all the weight go there and be light in the feet. We keep that heaviness through the feet. And then shifting to tilting your hips back so that you can then release the rest of the body down and you stay nicely grounded through the feet. And again, hips down, shift the weight into the feet. And as that you feel that yielding and that rebound effect, you can just roll up. Come all the way to standing. Taking your shoulders back. And then give your body a little shake. Okay. And then shake your hands out. Take a deep breath in. Hey. And exhale it out through the belly, through the pubic bone. Inhale. Hey, and begin to bounce. And bounce too with that letting go of the weight through the feet into the floor. Yielding in place. But also that gentle tone upwards. And let that shaking move into the elbows and into the shoulders. And shake out your belly and your waist. Really quite strongly. Shake out your lungs. See if you can move the lungs a bit and the internal organs. Take a deep breath in. Way. And as you exhale, really drop all your energy from head down to the lower part of the belly. This is how we organize our energy system. So let's do that again. Inhale deep. Oh, my necklace is... I was talking to Leon about how my necklace was stuck the last time. And here it goes again. That is asking for trouble, isn't it? Yes, it's gone again. Okay, so so give it a good shake. And then inhale again, deep. Exhale. Ah, good. And come back to bouncing. And feel the bounce in your belly. See if you can feel it into the internal organs. Gentle. Activating them. Stimulating them. And let your energy drop to the feet. You're already... The way we were busy with yielding and letting go did that already for us. Another deep, full breath. Okay, and then shake out the legs quickly, one at a time. Strongly.
And feel how this activates the whole body. So again, if you're in a pickle, if you really don't know what to do anymore, even if you don't know how to be present anymore, your shaking is your solution, because it's like this little snow globe. Everything whoop goes up and everything can then settle down after. All right, and then shake the whole body. And then imagine that big bucket of water, ice cold water. And what does the body do when it gets a whole big splash of ice cold water over it? It does this. Inhale deep. Everything. One more. Inhale. It's silly, but it works. Okay. And come to stillness. Open your eyes. Inhale. Lift your elbows. Float your energy to the heart. Exhale. Settle your energy to your lower belly. Turn the palms up. Inhale. Settle. Come to stillness. Elbows lift. Keep your shoulders relaxed and your arms and your wrists relaxed. Exhale, settle. So feel the floating of your energy and the settling. You literally rise a little, inhale. And you lower a little, exhale. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. One more. And let go. Feel the yielding here, so don't collapse. You let go consciously, but you stay dignified and alert. Skin soft, skeletal system strong, knees unlocked. Feel the grounding, the yielding, and at the same time the rebound of energy traveling up. And then come to a seated position. So remember, for the last 10 to 15 minutes, you can sit on a meditation pillow. Of course, you can sit on a chair or just get comfortable. It is always helpful in meditation that you can have your chest open and that you sit in your own strength. If you need to support yourself with your back, place something in the lower back so that you can keep that tilt of the pelvis and the chest stays open. Give yourself a moment to settle. Deep breath in. Long breath out. And to help settle, deep, just a normal breath in now, just a regular, natural one. Purse your lips as if holding a straw and breathe out through that straw gently. We don't really want to blow out the candle, that's a little bit away from us. So it's a gentle out breath. Inhale. Regular in breath, not deeper than normal. Pursing the lips, gently exhale, slowly. As if hearing the ocean very softly in the background, that's how the breath sounds on the out-breath. Inhale. Two more. Last one. and settle. And now check again when you've settled. Have you collapsed? Or are you propping yourself up with a lot of tension and you're not actually really letting go into gravity? And then see if you can find that middle ground where you're becoming soft, the skin melts, you feel the whole body, and you feel the floor. You're giving in to gravity, at the same time keeping a gentle tone to the body, a dignified, alert position, without holding yourself up away from the floor. So you're really connected to the earth. Trust that the earth is there, supporting you. We come from the earth, so let's relax into it. And then take a moment to turn our attention inward. And ask yourself the question, what is happening inside of me? And just notice. The sensations you may feel. And how the sensations make you feel. Notice if there's any tightness or tension in the body. You probably feel wherever it's tight in the body might show itself. Stay rooted. Keep giving into that pool of gravity. At the same time holding your dignified position, your posture. And then the question is, can you be with it? With whatever it is that you notice, whether it is that you're noticing tension in the upper back or in the head or in your wrist, it doesn't matter. Or whether you feel a sadness or a calmness or anger. Can you allow yourself to be with it without a need to judge it or change it? Invite whatever it is you're feeling to tea. That's how Thich Nhat Hanh described it, I believe. So you acknowledge whatever it is you feel, and if it's something a little bit disturbing that we normally would want to run away from, rather than running away from in mindfulness, we ask it to have tea with us. I see you, and now I'm going to be with you with love and compassion. Can you be with it? Can you just allow it? Can you just be and feel your direct experience? Even when it's super intense, can you just be with it? It doesn't have to be for a long period of time. And it's okay. And if you feel something really intense like rage or murderous thoughts about someone, which can happen when we're really angry with people, know that this doesn't mean that those thoughts are, we find them okay, or the feelings that, but it just means they're there. And then you're just allowing yourself to be with reality. That's the only way to shift them. Rather than just pretending they're not there, and then they do influence how we react. When you create that pause and the compassion to have tea with it, to sit with it, to be with it. We only give space to reality. You're saying yes to the reality, to whatever is here right now. That's all. And then you're in that sacred space. Where your power and your freedom lies. Where you can choose to respond from presence and love rather than from a very old habit or conditioning. Be with yourself and gently whisper yes to whatever you are noticing within yourself. And say to yourself, it's okay. It's okay. I see you. And I love you. I know you're there for a reason. Either trying to protect me or because you're afraid, it doesn't matter. I see you and I love you. Give space to it. To whatever it is you're feeling, peace or anxiety or anything in between. Softening. It's when we can be with, present with our emotions that we become aware of love and the ground of being, the loving awareness that we are. That which can hold all of it. And the pause, the recognizing how you feel and the allowing how you feel is the start of all of this. Without judgment. Then we can become aware of presence, loving presence. Come to your heart with your attention and from your heart feel into the space around you. From your heart feel presence, feel stillness and feel each other. This loving awareness that holds all of what we recognize and allow is the same loving awareness for all of us, and this is where we can meet. Beyond all of this is a space where we meet. And where we can wish each other well. And feel the love. Holding all of us. Okay. May all of us regularly throughout the day, take time to tune inward and recognize what we feel on a physical level, in sensations, on an emotional level, in feelings and emotions, and on a more mental level, in thinking and thoughts. Maybe be able to turn towards that and maybe be able to be with that without judgment. May all of us find those pauses between the stimulus at times and the response, where we know our freedom lies and our power. And maybe be reminded of taking a moment like that every day, a couple of times. Gently bringing your attention back to your body. And from your heart with gentleness, feel your neck and your head. Feel the front and the back of the torso, the hips and the legs and the feet. Feel the soles of the feet and the palms of the hands. Bring both hands to the heart. May all of us and all beings everywhere, without exception, find peace, the peace that lies beyond the comings and goings of things. May all beings everywhere be happy. And then gently, when you're ready, aware again of the whole body, of yourself, of the room you're in, you can deepen your breath and open your eyes on the next in-breath to come back. Okay, so I hope you feel grounded, that you understand the steps that will make your life so much more embodied and present. And if you want to know more and learn more about these techniques, then follow my course that starts next week. It starts on Tuesday the 4th, and it runs over 4 evenings next week and the week after. And it's all about teaching you how to deal with life when you go through crisis. And even if you're not in a crisis, the interesting thing is, when we hit a crisis, we either react the way we've always reacted, and usually in a crisis that's about turning away and numbing ourselves and then making it worse, or you learn there is an opportunity, because it's all new and you're not usually there, to pick up something that is lying around but not in your consciousness, not integrated yet. But if you don't have something else lying around, you will just fall into your old patterns. But when you have a toolbox that you learn in a course like that, or when you're already meditating, or you've followed all the weeks we've done this, then this is there for you to pick up when something like this is happening, and then you can work with it. So this is why it's so important to have this knowledge. I hope everybody has when they hit something big, because it's just hard. Okay, anyway, today I just hoped it made you lighter and that you enjoy your evening. And remember also, there's a suggested yoga class underneath if you want to do some more movement. And I'll be here again Monday at 5 o'clock, next Monday. So see you there, and have a wonderful evening or rest of the day, depending on where you are in the world. Thank you.